two. How y'all doing today? I am on my way to Wisconsin, working on some trucker tips, and thought I'd put one together for you. Today I think I'm going to talk about cooking appliances. Things that I find useful in the truck, and why I find them useful. To start off with, you need an inverter in your truck. My inverter is 1800 watts. If I leave Millis, ever leave Millis, I intend to take that inverter with me. And it'll go into my truck once I become an owner-operator. It'll save me a little bit of money. It's a good size inverter. Meanwhile, you need an 1800 watt inverter, 1500 watt if you don't want to get the 18, but you know, I like the 18. And then the microwave. The microwave is the first and probably the most useful item that you can use in the truck. I mean, I use it at least once a day, and I use it for quite a bit of the stuff that I make in here. But one of the little quirks about the microwaves seem to be that if they're not level, then they won't work. They'll come on and then they'll cut off and then they'll reset. And so you kind of have to work to get them level. So if your truck is sitting on an incline, then you need to prop up, you know, one end of it so that it's level. That way it'll work without any problem. I usually don't have a lot of problems with mine, but you know, currently it's sitting up here on the bunk also, so you know, I don't have it in a place where it's designed to be. So anyway, microwave. You know, everybody was raised with one these days. So telling you what to use a microwave for is kind of a waste of time. You really ought to have that one figured out. Second item is a crock pot. Right? Now, what I use is just a one quart crock pot. It's pretty small. It's pretty much I ain't gonna say it's the smallest one you can get, but it's pretty small. It runs about $10 at Walmart, and nothing special about it. You know, it's a simple, small, one quart crock pot. Pros and cons. On that size. Being that small, some of the items that I use and buy are actually designed to be in a crock pot twice that size, a 2 pound, a 2 quart crock pot. But 2 quarts of food is just too much. So you say, you can take the extra and you can bag it up, freeze it, and you got, dinners for the rest of the week. Yeah, that's true. Except for the fact that you have very limited space in your refrigerator. So, some of that stuff isn't going to be able to be recycled like that. I find the one quart crock pot, good enough. I can usually eat at least half of what's in there. Maybe save one meal, for the next day, or something like that. Usually I can pretty much knock out whatever I cook in there. Second con is the crock pot lining bags. You need to buy those. Believe me, they are invaluable. But they only make them for 2 quart crock pots. I haven't yet found one for a 1 quart crock pot, which is kind of a pain in the butt because 2 quart lining bags are way too big for what it is that I'm doing. It makes it a little bit difficult to use them, but you can manage. So there's a lot of things that you can do in a crock pot. You can do anything in a smaller crock pot that you can do in a bigger crock pot. Just do it on a smaller scale. And so you can have some pretty good healthy food, if you work it right. I don't like chicken, I do turkey, but you can make a turkey stew or a turkey soup, or you can make other kinds of soups, there's just a lot of things you can do with a crock pot. So it's definitely well worth having. I use mine not as much as the microwave, and there may go a whole week or so without me using it at all. But I use the crock pot quite a bit. especially if I'm running really hard, you know, and I've got a ship or a receiver that I'm at, you know, and I know I've got 2 or 3 hours of drive time left once I leave there, a lot of times I'll put a meal in the crock pot, strap it down real good, run the last couple hours out, dinner's cooked when I get where I'm going. So it's definitely worth having. Road Pro Oven. You can get these at pretty much any truck stop. The Road Pro Oven operates off of a 12-volt system. So it plugs into your cigarette lighter or your power adapters, which makes it pretty convenient. You don't have to have an inverter for that. So if you don't have an inverter, the Road Pro Oven may be one of the first things that you want to buy. And it's not that big, so but you don't really need it to be that big. And you buy these lining pans, aluminum lining pans. They're like bread pans. And you put them in there, you cook everything in the bread pan. You can do quite a bit of stuff in them. And, you know, you can do, I've done chili dogs, I've done macaroni and cheese, and hot dogs, and macaroni and cheese, and sausage. I made kind of like a chili mac type thing in there. You know, and it works pretty good for that. You know, it cooks really good. Again, it's one of those items that you can put, you can put on when you're a couple hours from your stop and just let it go ahead and cook all the way through. And there's a lot of stuff that you can, you know, you can do in that Road Pro oven. So it's a pretty good tool to have, and well worth having. Foreman grill. Now, I've got one in my truck, and Foreman grill, I mean, you can do a lot of things on that. You know, make grilled cheese sandwiches on the Foreman grill if that's what you want. But I got the Foreman grill so I can eat a little bit healthier. You know, I mean, I do a lot of turkey. I do a lot of fish, and I like to get fish fillets. You know, like salmon fillets or catfish fillets or tilapia. You know, and I can get like tuna steaks, swordfish. You know, even edge shark steaks. You know. And, cook those on the Foreman grill, season them up really good. Just light them on the grill, cook them. Good thing about a Foreman grill is that it cooks from both sides. So you can actually take a frozen product, you know, like frozen tilapia, put it straight on the grill, and it'll cook it all the way through pretty quick. It doesn't take too long. And because the Foreman grill is designed to cook without grease, it drains all the grease off of it. Pretty easy to clean, so Foreman grill is another one of my go-to items, something that I need. I'll actually probably be using it tonight. Planning on doing some tilapia tonight, maybe with a little bit of macaroni and cheese. So the Foreman grill and the microwave are both probably going to get used tonight. The microwave with the Mac and the Foreman grill for the tilapia. That's probably what I'm going to do tonight. So, there's a guy out there, some of y'all that watch me, you know, you may already watch him also, but he goes by the Little Trucker Guy. Little Trucker Guy is the name of the show, so look that up. And he just did a preview the other day, or a show the other day on using a NutriBullet, where he's making juices, and I've tried that before, and I haven't had very good luck with it. But after watching his deal the other night, it's kind of got me thinking, you know, that may be something that I'm going to want to get from my truck, you know, because I need to start trying to eat a little healthier and start trying to make some better choices on the foods that I eat. That NutriBullet that he had, you know, and the juice that he made, you know, it really looked pretty decent. I'm not sure yet about putting peanuts in it. You know, I mean, I guess that's one I'm just gonna have to try. You know, but you know, I'll tell you what, man, I was kind of impressed with his review of it, and you know, I was impressed enough by it that I'm thinking seriously about putting that on my list of items that I really want to have for the truck. And maybe start doing a little bit of that healthier juicing. You know, and I've tried, like I said, I've tried this before, and it hasn't really worked for me. I just haven't been able to find a blend that I would think it would be any good. But I was watching, you know, him do that yesterday, and you know, it looked good. So what I'm thinking about doing is trying to talk my wife into making one of those juices at home and giving me a review of what she thought about it. Because if she doesn't like it, I know I'm not going to like it. You know, if she does like it, then, you know, I might like it. So we've got a ninja at the house, and so making a juice like that, the ninja's no big deal. We can knock that out in no time. It's definitely something that I'm considering doing. So, watch his video. Look him up, Little Trucker Guy. And watch that video. Look for the Nooch Bullet. And let me know what you think. I definitely think that it's something worth having. I will try. I'm not going to promise, but I will try to pull up his video and post a link to it and my description below. All right. If I don't, and if I forget, and it's not there in the description, put that in the comments and remind me that I did not do that, and I'll find it, and I'll edit it, and I'll put it in there, okay? Because, you know, it's really a pretty good item that he's got. So, anyway, that's my tip for today on the cooking appliances for the truck. You know, some of y'all may think it's a little over the top, and you don't need that much, you know, and that's fine. You know, I mean, everybody don't have to do everything the way I do it. I'm just telling you that these are the things that I found useful, and these are the things that I like to have in my truck. And, you know, give it a shot. You know, if you don't think it's useful, then, you know, hey, that's cool. But, you know, it's there to try to help you out. And ultimately, that's why I do these videos. That's to help you guys out. Let you know what I've found, and, you know, things that have worked for me. And, you know, that way maybe you can try it. Maybe it'll work for you, you know. But ultimately, my view of this whole life out here, and I know it's not shared, you know, and maybe it's a little antiquated, you know, and it doesn't really fit these days. But my idea of this whole life out here is that you know, together we make up a community. You might call it a brotherhood, or you might call it whatever it is, you know, but together we make a community, and, you know, we're all out here together. You know, we're all doing this job together. You know, you can be part of a group and say, you know, you're grinding, you know, and I'm down for that. You know, ruthless grinders go hard, you know. But, you know, that's not the whole community. That's just a part of that community. You know, you could be an old school trucker, you know, and hey, I'm down for that, man. I'm all the way there with you. Man, my dad was an old school trucker, you know. So I'm all the way behind that, you know. Even if you don't like all us new guys, you know, we're still part of that same community, you know. And when we're out here together, you know, we're doing this together, I think we should, you know, work to help each other. You know, I don't really think we should be dragging each other down, calling each other names, you know, trying to talk trash about how one person does something as opposed to how another person does something. So, you know, my whole purpose behind all these videos is to help you. And if you get anything useful out of it, then I'm happy. You know, don't get me wrong, I'd love to have a lot of subscribers, you know. I mean, the more subscribers I have, the more my videos are getting out there. You know, the more the people are seeing them, the more the people are, you know, commenting on them, you know, and giving me input to do things better. You know, but I'm not doing it, you know, for subscribers. You know, don't get me wrong, I'd love to have, you know, thousands of views, you know, because the more views that I have, the more that I know they're being seen, and therefore, you know, the more they're getting out there. there, but you know, I'm not doing it for views. You know, I'm doing it to help. That's all I want to do is help. I make some friends along the way, you know, meet some people, hook up with some folks, maybe do some videos with some of these guys that do videos, you know. I think that'd be really cool to do. But the rest of the time, you know, all I'm trying to do is help folks. You know, I'm not the most experienced guy, I don't claim to be. I'm learning every day. You know, every day I pick up something new. And, you know, my goal is to share that stuff with you. So if I've succeeded in that, I'm happy. If not, let me know what I can do better. And, until later on, you know, share the videos, comment, post, you know, like, subscribe, all that kind of stuff. And, you know, until next time, man. Y'all take care. Keep between the lines. Peace out.